What's up, guys? James Spawn here with Immortals.com, and like I mentioned in my most anticipated games of 2016 video, I decided to put together another list of games that we're super excited for, but might not exactly see in 2016, and with each one I'll give you sort of an explanation as to why. So with this list I've tried to include games that I know you guys are also looking forward to as well, which will hopefully give you some insight or update on their current development from our understanding, but mainly it's all just speculation, so definitely want to keep that in mind. So starting out we've got Lost Ark, a game that you guys have been asking about a lot recently. Okay, so with Lost Ark, it's very safe to say that we are extremely excited to see it too. This game is going to be freaking epic. It's a badass looking dungeon crawler with a crazy cool combo system, open world environments, a huge world map at that, awesome playable classes, and plenty more. But we're realists. That game is going to be a massive undertaking. The problem is, the game has been really under the radar since its big 2014 G-Star reveal, and all we know now is that development is continuing, and just a couple of months ago they began limited focus group testing in Korea, so to expect it in the West in 2016 is sort of a pipe dream based on what we know about the time it takes games launching in the Asian market to reach the West, if they even do. So in all honesty, the localization alone is going to take at least a year. What we're hoping for now is that it doesn't take as long as Blade and Soul did to come to the West. I hate to say it, but you're probably going to have to set your calendars for early 2019, and really hope we're wrong and it happens sooner. Next up is another game often asked about, Kingdom Under Fire 2. Well, not too long ago, we almost saw this game in the West. They were that close to not region blocking the game when they started testing in Southeast Asia this past year. The thing is, Kingdom Under Fire 2 is, as of now, essentially in the same state as Phantasy Star Online 2, with the only difference being just that. They blocked Western IPs from the English-Malaysian version. Now, this typically means that they have plans to sell the game there and then unlock it again. So, just like PSO2, there is literally nothing holding them back except that. And we'd think they'd want to start building hype for the Western release, but for whatever reason, they just haven't, making us wonder what hidden agenda or limitation is blocking them. It could be just publisher agreements, which is really simple and it just takes time, or it could be something way worse. Either way, the game is ready to go, as you can easily tell, so we should see it soon. Or it might go the same way as PSO2 and never be heard from again. Let's hope not. And then we have World of Speed. Now, World of Speed is getting absolutely no love from My.com to push towards a Western launch. After Ubisoft stole the Western market with The Crew, both My.com and KOG Games, who's also working on a racing game called Ultimate Race, went silent on marketing their racing game, so basically hibernating through the winter, so to speak. Currently, there's only one localization developer and one moderator in charge of maintaining the English World of Speed website, and other than the occasional screenshot, there really hasn't been any official update on the Western beta since December 2014, and that was to promise a late 2015 beta test that never happened. And again, just like Kingdom Under Fire 2 and PSO2, World of Speed is in a very ready-to-play state of development, as you can clearly see from their gameplay trailers. However, with the game development continuing in Russia, we at least know the game isn't dead. At the My.com and Obsidian Entertainment press event that I got to go to a few months back, they did bring up World of Speed briefly, but when we asked about it, it pretty much just got shifty eyes. The good kind, like something is happening, but, you know, it's all secret for now. So it's just a matter of if My.com really wants to invest the resources in making it available here in the West. We think that's the case, we just can't tell when. Up next, we have The Repopulation, which is another game we're really excited to see based on its cool ideas, but it's a bit of a tragic story, honestly. After restarting their development from the ground up twice already, for those of you that follow their dev blogs early on already know this, they're finally narrowing in on a launch, which would have probably ended up sometime mid-2016. However, in December, an issue arose with Idea Fabric internally, who is responsible for the hero engine that the game is built on. So, with Idea Fabric out of the picture, the Repopulation servers are dead in the water as well. So, as of now, there's literally no way to transfer the game over to a new game engine. So, until Hero Engine is back online, development on the game and even alpha testing is completely over. Let's hope that it doesn't mean for good. Along the same lines as Lost Ark, we have Monster Hunter Online. So this game was developed with the stated intention of being a Chinese-only MMORPG. However, given the combination of the game's success in China so far, and the immediate reaction of Western fans still clamoring and denied a proper PC online Monster Hunter game. Instead, we get stuff like Dragomon Hunter. No offense. It isn't too far out to think that they might reconsider their stance and give it a Western shot after all. Unfortunately, it's not very likely, given how few Chinese-focused MMORPGs have succeeded in recent memory, but with the Chinese games receding from the West more than ever, if there was ever one we might see make the oceanic jump, it's Monster Hunter Online. But honestly, this one is hard to speculate on, and it's all pure speculation at the end of the day. Now here's a big one that's happening stateside. What's going on with EverQuest Next and Landmark? Well, unfortunately, Daybreak Games is undoubtedly in a sorry state following their break from Sony. They've been bleeding quality talent faster than any developer we've ever seen before. With their entire old guard gone, including former president John Smedley, development announcements on their titles has slowed to a crawl. Outside of DCUO, PlanetSide 2, and an occasional H1Z1 tournament, very little information has followed in terms of development, especially for their unreleased titles like EverQuest Next, Landmark, and H1Z1. While we're fairly confident that H1Z1 is still likely to launch sometime this year, we sort of held off from our most anticipated list because we're honestly starting to feel that they're more than likely taking it to the buy-to-play route because it makes more sense financially. I mean, it's already that way, sort of. All they have to do is keep it going with a buy-in price past its launch date. And unfortunately, Smedley himself has confirmed that much of the revolutionary AI systems set to make EverQuest Next and Landmark next-gen titles was cut due to budget restraints. So, as it looks right now, these games will likely never launch, or at the very least, feel really rushed and basically a shell of their former glory. All we can do now is hope for the best with Daybreak Games. Now, these next two you might have accidentally forgot about. First up is Civilization Online. Now, Civ Online is the unholy combination of taking ArcheAge's sandbox technology and mashing in Realm vs. Realm elements to fit the bill for Firaxis' dream of turning their 4X strategy icon, Civilization, into an MMORPG. With the now wiser and well-funded XL Games in the driver's seat on the project, all signs point to an epic and innovative title, and soon, those with access to the Korean servers will know for sure, as it's in its final stages of closed beta before launch. However, after ArcheAge's very rough reception in the West, no thanks to Tryon, the future of a localized Civ Online is very much in question, though Firaxis has repeatedly stated that if the demand is there and the outcry is loud enough, we certainly intend to see the game published in the West. So as the saying goes, if you want something bad enough, complain on the internet. If you build the fan base, it will come. Next up, we have RPL. Now, RPL is Nexon's answer to both Hero Wars and Tree of Savior, offering gameplay that's about the middle point, if you can imagine a middle point between the two. The key difference is coming in that Nexon has been a bit more slow and precarious in development and hasn't stepped on the landmines that Tree of Savior now finds itself in. Still, given their cautious approach to launch, we felt that slapping a 2016 tag on this potential gem would be setting ourselves up for disappointment. So, I say, join us in taking a wait-and-see approach on RPL. Looks like the game actually hit open beta testing in Korea this month, so should your plans for Hero Wars or Tree of Savior fall through, 2017 should have your back with a serious kick-ass anime ARPG. Already worth looking forward to. And last but not least, we've got one that I've really been looking forward to called Hunt, Horrors of the Gilded Age. Now, it was part of the most anticipated game of 2015 because we heard about it then, and it looked like this even at E3 2014. It's a four-player co-op game, kind of like Evolve, where you play as a hunter who tracks down and kills creatures created by lore and myth, kind of like killing the boogeyman or the chupacabra. Check out some gameplay. The idea here is really awesome. Now, the game looks polished, from my standpoint anyway, so why does it take 2 years or longer from this point in order to get into beta? Well, besides just the financial troubles of Crytek in 2014, they actually announced closed beta for the game back then, but then they delayed it even further. Crytek at that time also decided to do some restructuring, which involved the closure of the US branch as a development studio, which had been working on Hunt. From that point, they decided to move the game to its development headquarters in Frankfurt, Germany. And then after that, we basically got 7 months or so of dead silence. I mean, their website still hasn't changed. Nothing. The good news-ish is that as of November 2015, some conversations have popped up on Twitter discussing the status of the game. Now, the brand manager for Crytek has stated that the development of Hunt is ongoing and going well. So, Are we going to see this game in 2016? It's really hard to say at this point. My guess is that we might see beta if we hope hard enough, which is what I'm doing. At least the game hasn't been canceled. So there you go, guys. Those are just a few of the major games that we're keeping our eyes on in hopes that we see them sooner rather than later. Hopefully this gives you guys some insight as to what's happening in some of these games that you might be looking forward to as well. And if not, well, maybe you're looking forward to them now. Again, a lot of this is just pure speculation, so tell us what you think and hope to see in 2016 and beyond in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check the links in the description below for more information about all of these games. And until next time, guys, that's going to be it for me. I'm James Blonde. See you out there, gamers.